floor or slab system in buildings. Reinforced concrete building structures are a combination of different structural systems. It involves vertical systems, horizontal systems, and lateral system. Floor or slab systems are a type of horizontal structural system that are intended to resist the gravity loads like dead and live loads acting over it and to safely transfer them to the vertical systems like columns. Features of slab system in RCC building structures. A slab system or floor system possesses the following features. Safe transfer of loads to the below structural system, serve as a horizontal diaphragm to connect and stiffen other structural elements, act as a rigid floor diaphragm under the action of lateral loads and distribute safely to vertical frame elements, maintain floor geometry during lateral load action. Different types of floor or slab systems for buildings. In a cast in situ RCC building, a slab system can be of following types. A wall-supported slab system, a beam-supported slab system, ripped slab system, flat plate system, and flat slab system. Number 1. Wall-supported slab system. There are slab or floor systems supported on load-bearing masonry walls. The important features of such wall systems are floor slabs have thickness between 100 to 200 mm while constructed, span range between 3 to 7.5 meters. They are mainly adopted in low-rise buildings and can be supported on opposite spans called as one-way slab or can be supported on all the slabs or the slab sides that are called as two-way slabs. Beam-supported slab system. These are systems in which floor slabs are supported on beams instead of walls. During construction, the slabs are constructed monolithically with beams in a grid pattern. It is used for slabs of span between 3 and 7.5 meters. It is adopted for high-rise building and low-rise frame construction. Gravity loads from the slabs are transferred directly to the beams and then to the columns. An important note to be noted is that when the beams are directly connected to the columns in the vertical frame, then the beams are called as a primary beam or girders. When the beams supporting the slabs are not supported directly by a column, but by other primary beams, then those beams are called as secondary beams, as shown in the figure clearly. Number 3. Ripped slab system. This is a unique slab system in which the slab, which is called as topping, is thin, say 50 to 100 mm, and placed over closely spaced slender beams that are called as ribs. The spacing of the ribs are less than 1.5 meters. The thickness of the ribs used to support the slabs are not less than 65 mm and a depth 3 to 4 times the thickness. A ripped slab system is called as a grid floor. It can be constructed as one-way or a two-way system. Two-way ripped slab is called as a waffle slab system. It can be constructed either cast in situ or precast. Flat plate system. In the system, the floor slab is supported directly on the columns without using stiffening beams except at their peripheries as shown. Number 5. Flat slab system. These are slab systems in which flat slab plates are stiffened near the column support using drop panels or column capitals that are concealed under the drop ceilings. Compared to flat plate system, flat slabs can take higher loads and larger spans. This enhanced property is because the drop panels at the column slab intersection improves shear and hogging moment resistance at the junction. The thickness of flat slab varies between 125 to 300 mm for spans of 4 to 9 meters. These slabs possess higher dead loads per unit area compared to other systems. For more videos, if you like this video, let us know by liking, sharing, and subscribing to our channel, Engineering Fanatics.